The solution of the previous quiz said that we had to define the wide detail fragment layout in two places, the layout LAN and the layout SW600DP folder. To avoid having multiple copies of this file, we should use layout aliasing. We can check the documentation for layout aliases to see an example. Say we have a main layout file that's for one pane UI. In the layout large and layout SW600DP folders, we want a multi-pane layout. In case you're wondering, layout large is for backward compatibility purposes for large devices prior to Android 3.2. That's when the SW qualifiers were introduced. So back to the point. To avoid code duplication, we can define the two-pane layout in the base layout folder. Then in the values large and values SW600DP folders, we can create a reference so that the main layout actually maps to the two-pane layout. In the Java code, you can reference it as r.layout.main, but it's actually referencing the two-pane layout. This is what the detail fragment should look like afterwards. And this is what the phone landscape view looks like. If you rotate the device, the phone portrait view should be different. In the next coding task, we're going to make the today list item look more like the other items in the list for the tablet.